Hey guys, Bex here. I just want to share a little bit about being honest today. I don't know about you, but coronavirus and lockdown has had its challenging moments. I've felt God speak to me on a number of things, and felt like, yeah, I need to work through a few things, and it's been tough, I'll be honest with you. It's been hard work, and so what I really want to share is being honest about where we are. I think it can be easy for us to fall into the trap of pretending that we've got it all sorted, pretending that we know what we're doing, pretending that we're flawless, when in reality we know that none of us are. And the story that's sort of come to mind about, you know, being honest with where I'm at has been actually the story of David and Goliath. So there's a bit where David's preparing to fight Goliath and he goes to Saul, and Saul's like, right, what you need is my armour, there you go, you need my huge sword, and that's what'll help you win the battle against Goliath. And David tries it on and it's massive on him and it doesn't fit. See, he's a little lad, and he's not used to wielding a sword. He doesn't know how to do that. He's never been trained to do that. He's used to being in the fields and fighting off bears and tigers against the sheep. He uses a sling and some stones, and that's how he fights. He's never been taught how to wield a sword. And so David turns Saul down, and I always think, you know, wow, that must have taken quite a bit of courage from David to be like, actually, Saul, I think you're wrong here, mate. I think I need my sling. You know, because Saul's like the commander of an army. I think he knows how to fight. But David knew himself, and he was honest, and he was like, I've never been taught these things. I don't know what I'm doing with that. So, you know, and he was honest about where he was. And even the other night, I felt God speak to me and he was saying, you know, you cannot fully step into what I have for you until you're honest with yourself about where you are, until you're honest with me about where you are. You can never fully step into what I have for you, because you know what happens when you do that? You're not giving your whole self to God, because you're not being honest. So you're saying to God, okay, God, you can have this bit because I like that bit, and that's fine. You can have that, but I'm keeping this little bit to myself because I don't want to be honest with you. It's too painful. It hurts. I don't want to deal with all of that, so I'm going to pretend that it doesn't exist, or I'm going to pretend I know what I'm doing, or I'm not really going to think about it, so, you know, I don't have to deal with it. You know, and I fully believe that if David had not been honest and had taken Saul's armour, he would have got killed. I would put good money on that. But because he was honest and he knew himself and he knew who he was in God and he knew his skills and what he was good at, he did incredible things. And I think the same is true for us. Once we're honest with where we are, once we're honest about that, we can truly step into what God has for us. We can truly understand forgiveness and grace and these incredible things that God has. And he can do a work in us and through us. And it hurts. It hurts, and it's painful, and it's costly. But I think we all know that if something costs a lot, even, you know, in monetary value, if it costs a lot, it's worth something. And, you know, God asks everything of us because he's worth it. He asks everything of us. He's the most expensive yet free. Weird. But he asks everything of us because he's so good and he's so gracious and he's worth it. He's worth everything. So yeah, that's sort of a few things that I've been learning over the past few weeks, and yeah, I hope it blesses you. and I pray great things for your coming week, and yeah, see you soon. Bye.